Can you quantify what makes Grace Jones the undisputed icon that she is, specifically musically?
That's a very big question. Unique, for real, never any compromise. A good example is before we made Hurricane, she hadn't recorded in 19 years. If she had, it would have been impossible for us to make the record that we made, to recontextualize and to bring her back, obeying no rules, just doing her own thing.
Of course, looking to the future, you guys have been working on and off for the last couple of years on a new album. Can you talk a little bit about what fans can expect from that and when that might eventually be coming to fruition?
It will come to fruition. The idea was to base it in Africa. So Africa has been implicit in Grace and in her music for some time, and we decided to make it explicit. So it's based around African folk music, the new album. And we're about 75% done with that.
I mean, obviously, that's always been an influence in Grace's creative work. Why do you think it was important for her and for you to make that, like you say, an explicit influence this time?
Well, for me, when I was thinking about, are we going to make another record, are we not going to make another record, it's like, where can we go that we haven't been before? There was a certain amount of pressure. Her profile is risen now to do... she's arrived.
She's holding my hand.
Certain amount of pressure to capitalize on this success, and we decided to go the other direction and deeper into the myth, if you like. Deeper into the myth of Grace Jones. So that's why we chose to go back, in a way, instead of cashing in on the commercial possibilities at this point. As I say, the reason we're going to Africa, we had a new idea, just following the myth of Grace. This record is going to sound like nothing she's done before, and I don't think it sounds like anything anyone else is doing particularly. So we never think about that. We never operate in the commercial sphere, really, anyway, in our thinking. So no, I think she'll be strong and even more unique than ever, as you can see over there somewhere. Yeah. Well, I think... At bottom, the ground is that the work is of very, very high quality. Then you've got political issues, you've got issues of race, you've got issues of sexuality, now you've got issues of age. Grace is a person who presses everyone's buttons just by existing. So if your artistic content is strong enough to get her into the public eye, her very existence seems to affect people and break barriers down by itself, really.
Why is Grace Jones such an undisputed icon?
I don't know. That's why I'm here, to find out from her mouth and from her story. We know the obvious things, but this woman is kind of, she's human, but she's superhuman. And she speaks for so many things over decades. If you think about how things change over time, to remain so important, is something that I can't quite fathom being of this generation, because we're used to things that go in and out, nobody cares, and then they care. She's Grace Jones, she's been here since before I was born, doing her. So I'm excited to kind of soak up her story today, and I know it's going to challenge me so much in a good way, and I'm going to be sort of inspired again.
I think obviously throughout Grace's long and eclectic career, the one common theme has always been breaking boundaries. Do you think that's a mission that continues today, and do you think we're making progress on some of those things?
I think it's a difficult time. There's so much happening, and there's such a lot of negativity and brokenness and chaos and destruction in the world. It can sometimes feel, I know as an artist, a bit overwhelming. Where does your focus lie? But I think all the more the need for really strong voices who are saying sound things and finding creative and interesting, fresh ways to say things. I think we need courage, our generation. I think it requires like a kind of courage that's not easy today, because people are so worried about being in and out, you know? I know what that feels like, so, yeah. Something really, really good, it's still, like, falling from the sky, so I really don't know where it's gonna be, but I have this... I just have this genuine, feeling that's... deep that it's going to be something exciting and stepping outside of myself again, and collaborative, maybe more so this time around. But we'll see. Like, I, you know, I'm just remembering how to eat my vegetables again and like sleep more than 4 hours at night. So once I get back on my feet, I think, you know, writing will come.
You just, you know, with digital video, and you know, this is all shot on mini DV tapes, you've got it, you know, a bag, you can put it over your shoulder, pick up a tripod like that, and out the door, and you can start making film. So all of the documentary footage I shot myself, did the sound myself, just with a, you know, a small kit, and you can create, you know, anything with that. But to really capture her performance, then I needed to get much more investment to do justice to it, to shoot on film, to create a show that for the camera would have that Grace Jones kind of graphic force. You know, the band are fantastic, but I wanted to create something that was theatrical, because Grace loves theatre. She sees herself in a theatrical context, more than a rock and roll context, really. So I wanted to create the conditions for her performance to kind of happen. And that took a lot of time, because it takes time to raise finance. You know, it wasn't like I was doing it against another form, but, you know, it's just that I'm just not the person to call if you want to make a kind of a biography channel film. It's just not, doesn't turn me on as a filmmaker. I like to kind of be in the world, freewheeling, creating material. I love ideas, and, you know, I spoke a lot with Grace, and, you know, a lot of what I learned about what she feels about performance and what she feels about her life informs how I put the film together. So, you know, I remember once she made, I remember her saying, oh, you mean those films where people sit and talk about you who didn't even know you? You know, so we weren't doing that. But this is actually, like, if you think of films like Don't Look Back, you know, this is also a very classic way to make a documentary about music, which is simply to be in the moment with those people, because you're making a documentation. You're not doing a commentary. You're not looking back and say, let's all think about the time when we weren't here. This film is saying, be here now. For 2 hours, you're going to be intimately in Grace Jones' world. That's the kind of film I make the films that I like to see. You know, so it's, and I like to make a document, because it's a little tiny gesture against the truth of our mortality, that, you know, you make a document and it's there. And that's what film is, you know. Film is, you know, as a film theorist said, it's death at 24 frames a second. We're asked to say this, but the truth is, it's just a kind of, you know, she's obviously a fantastic person. I love the way she thinks. I love the way she expresses herself. And to film, for me, that was just like, I felt like the cat who got the cream, you know, because she was so beautiful to frame, and, you know, to sort of understand how to frame her, and, you know, capturing moments. People say to me, oh, were you scared when she was shouting to Robbie Shakespeare on the phone? You know, I was really trying to make sure that, you know, I wasn't over-recording the sound, the sharp, you know, should I make a close-up or a wide, you know. So I have to be very craft orientated even when I'm filming. So it's all these different parts of you that you kind of need to engage when you're making documentary, because you don't have a script. So then you get to the edit, and that is very exciting, because you kind of have to find your film in the material. And it's not like you have an imposed idea from the start. You know, it's not like I had an agenda. Oh, I want to say this about Grace Jones. I had to discover what the film could do, what the film said, what those moments of her, in all of their truth, could reveal, and make it as complex and as multi-layered and multi-narrative as possible, really, so that it's like a rich, it's a rich meal. You know?
Grace, lovely to meet you.
I'm squeaking through this.
It's okay. I know you're honouring your lovely mother today.
Yes.
What do you think she would make of all of this and the documentary?
Oh, she's seen it. She's in it.
Yeah, I know.
Actually, and... Oh, boy.
I don't want to upset you.
Not upsetting. I'm already upset, so you're not upsetting me at all.
I feel like...
I feel her spirit watching this and saying, You be strong like a bull. I go, Mom, you're a goat. I'm a bull. She go, who is stronger? Goat. Bull. Goat. So now I'm being a goat like her. Trust. Yep. Fly on the wall, trust, and my adopted sister.
And creative experiment. We like to, we're creative people.
We like are to make so experiments. Much alike. We are really so much alike.
Yeah. As you said, it's been 10 years now. What was it about Sophie that made you want to say yes to doing this?
Immediately.
She saw my work.
It was immediate with my brother.
Yeah.
That's how we got introduced with her film with my brother. And we looked at each other. I said,
I remember
let's
we had
do this. It's a very different time now with the technology. I have a son. I have a granddaughter now. It's really different as far as going forward artistically with the internet and all that stuff. I'm totally not into that. I don't see the art form of actually going forward with that. I'm confused, to be honest with it. Honestly, you know, because you can have on internet, oh, you have like, I don't know, 100 million tweets, views, this, that, but how do you go forward? How do you go forward? For me right now, it's a big question mark. I believe a live performance is the key to go live. And that's all I can say that I believe that a performer and artist can do is to go live. Show, sing, paint, do it live. And that's it.